Good day, everyone. Today I'm going to talk about a game that I played as Russia. My overall strategy in this game playing Russia was to sort of create a buffer with both Austria and Germany, so basically align myself with both of those and start fighting in the north, Scandinavia versus England, maybe even grab Edinburgh, and in the south versus Turkey. Now let's see what happened, and let's see how this game progressed. So in spring 1991 I make quite a normal opening. Again, I'm focusing north, so army Moscow moves to St. Petersburg, and other than that, I'm moving to Romania. Austria and I respect the DMZ in Galicia, so that all goes fine. Two important things to notice is Germany and France immediately bounce in Burgundy, and England, as I agreed with him, moves to the English Channel, meaning conflict, or at least some kind of friction between him and France. Apologies. I agree on a bounce with Turkey in the BLA, so it's prearranged. In the fall, I do quite well. England tries to move into Belgium and tries to move into Mao, which he actually secedes. But because of that, I'm taking Norway and I'm also taking Sweden because Germany had moved to Holland. I'm also grabbing Romania, so perfect. I end up with 7 supply centers, as you can see on the top right. I decide not to provoke either Austria or Germany. And hence leave Warsaw empty. So I'm building 2 fleets in the north coast of St. Petersburg and Sevastopol, and an army in Moscow. Obviously the fleet built in Sevastopol will provoke Turkey, and also the fleet built on St. Petersburg north coast might provoke England. But I'm good with Germany, I'm good with Austria, so I'm quite happy. And again, 3 builds in 91 is not bad. In the spring I rearrange my units in the north, and yeah, in the south I basically stand put, but I do decide to support Austria into Bulgaria, meaning our alliance is growing. Turkey will have to disband that unit, and I'm bouncing on the Black Sea again. In the fall, I decide to grab Norwegian Sea, and I kind of let Turkey onto the Black Sea, but at the same time I'm moving into Armenia and into Sevastopol. With the fact that Turkey has no build, I'm pretty confident I can take the Black Sea in the next season. In the north I'm just progressing but not taking any gains yet. Which I'm also sort of happy about, because having 7 centers after year one is kind of aggressive, so I'm quite happy that I didn't take anything else. England is finally getting his build in Belgium, so he's building a new fleet in Edinburgh, which causes me some problems because I wanted to attack him, of course. But other than that, I'm quite happy with the situation as it is. At the same time, what I have seen is that Italy and Turkey have allied and hence taken Greece from Austria, which is a dangerous development for me, because I don't want Austria to die again. I like this Germany-Austria buffer for me to be able to fight both Turkey and England. So in 1903, I move into Clyde to take Liverpool in the fall. And as I told you, I'm taking the Black Sea, a very important step in the Russia-Turkey conflict, obviously. Germany and France are fighting a little bit. It seems that Germany is allied with England at the moment, because England is supporting them into Burgundy, but that's all fine. Austria, again, is being attacked hard by Italy, which partially explains why he has no time to even think about a move against me. In the fall, you see me moving into Clyde, grabbing my number 8 supply center. And I'm making progression against Turkey. I'm not taking any supply centers yet, but it will come. I'm also have a pre-arranged bounce in Bulgaria with Austria, which was a wise idea because also Italy decided to move there. Yeah, so extra build. Decide to build an army, this time in Warsaw. Not because I want to provoke either Austria or Germany, but yeah. It just makes most sense because I want to use it in the south. Again, I have gained 1 supply center, also Austria has gained 1, and both Italy and England have lost 1, which is good news for me. But then things go south. Germany sees the danger that I'm posing and he decides to go all out to the east. So he's moving an army into Sweden, which fails, thank God, but he's also moving into the Baltic Sea and moving into Silesia. At the same time, I'm making progress in the Balkans, basically by attacking Bulgaria, which also should offend Austria. Thank God Austria is very busy with Italy. They're keeping each other entangled very nicely. And of course, I also have Turkey under pressure. But the moves from Germany are very concerning. So Germany actually managed to take Sweden in the fall. England takes Liverpool back for me, and I'm not taking Edinburgh, which I have hoped, which I had hoped. So thank God I'm taking Ankara here. And I'm also taking Serbia because I'm retreating from Bulgaria to Serbia. So overall, I don't lose a supply center, but my position has weakened big time. Because Serbia, as you can see, is surrounded by enemy units, so it's very doubtful whether I can hold it. Austria is anyway weakened by the Italian attack. And Germany and England have gained a supply center. And normally I would have liked that for Germany, but Germany is being very aggressive against me, so this plus one here is a direct result of Sweden, which I don't like. So no good news. I decided to disband the fleet here and basically built a new one in St. Petersburg South Coast. Now in 1905 this German offensive continues, which is not good news. He's actually convoying an army from Berlin into Livonia and he's attacking Warsaw. At the same time against Turkey I'm continuing my offensive, which is good news. England luckily gets a little bit distracted by France, so the Germany-England coalition is progressing slowly. And again, Italy and Austria are fighting a big time battle over Trieste. Then in the fall, I defend Warsaw in the following way. I bounce with Silesia and I cut the support in Livonia with my fleet. But I already see the problem coming with England. So England is taking Norway for me and also fighting me out of the Norwegian Sea. Unfortunately, he hasn't looked at the retreat options. Unfortunately for him, not for me. But this danger in Scandinavia is big time. So my original plan where I wanted to grab supply centers in Scandinavia has completely turned around by this point. I'm just happy to defend there. Actually decide to break down my fleet in the Gulf of Bothnia, but keep my fleet in the North Sea to basically piss off England. He will not like that. In the south everything is going relatively okay, but I have lost a supply center. So basically by winter 1905 I'm in the same position in supply centers as by winter 1901. So 4 years later I've not made much progress, which is sad. And again, this Germany-England coalition is killing it for me. So at that point I'm also kind of diplomacy-wise getting the turnaround with Germany. Germany is seeing that the progress he's getting from attacking me is limited. And I'm not posing so much of a threat to him anymore, because with seven supply centers, I'm not that big anymore. So I decide to retreat my army from St. Petersburg, because I already see coming that Germany and England are starting to attack that. And I need the army in Moscow to defend against Livonia and Silesia. But I'm actually diplomatically in a better position, because Germany sees that the situation is not that dangerous anymore for him. I do attack Germany and Denmark, but hey, what the hell does it matter? He's also attacking me in Scandinavia and in St. Petersburg. So in the fall, I'm still battling with Germany. I'm defending Warsaw here. He has a supported attack, but I also have a supported attack. And I'm making progress against Turkey, so I'm taking both Bulgaria and Constantinople. It's very important for me. You see Austria struggling with Italy. That will remain for the rest of the game. Trying to attack England here. Maybe I should have gone for Norway, but yeah, that's always easy in hindsight. So what you see is I actually, despite losing St. Petersburg, I do get a build in Warsaw because of all the gains I get in the south. So instead of using the gains in the north to gain momentum in the south, I'm actually using my gains in the south, on the Balkans and in Turkey, to sort of defend in the north. But this army that I built fresh in Warsaw is very important because Germany is now facing a situation with two armies against three of my armies. That's also a strategical mistake that England and Germany made, because the fleet here is not, it's not doing anything for England. If it would have been an army, they would have been in a much better position to attack Moscow and hit me in the core of my center. So supply center wise, I gain one. Austria is down to two, so leaving the battlefield soon. Italy, France and Germany are the powers to take into account, and England so far yes, but we'll see what happens. So after all this diplomatic effort with Germany, he decides to retreat. I'm obviously not taking any chances and kick him out of Livonia anyway, but I'm very glad he retreats and I promise him not to attack him and I will keep my word about that for very long. So I focus on England. do a bounce in Norway to make sure that St. Petersburg can be taken in the fall, and I continue my offensive against Turkey. Grabbing both Greece and Smyrna from Turkey, but unfortunately he can move to Constantinople, so he's not dead yet. At the same time, doing all kinds of funny things here with England to get a foothold in Scandinavia again. And you see, I'm very happy that I kept that fleet in the North Sea, which is now in Skagerrak, because that's causing England so many headaches that helps me so much in driving him back. So this is a good year for me. Two new supply centers. England has to break down one. So I'm extremely happy. I'm now at 10 supply centers, but it's also 19-7 by now. But you can see I'm starting to become the dominant force. England at 4, Germany and France at 6, Italy at 5, so I really have some momentum now. My next priorities are obviously eliminating Turkey, also eliminating Austria, because Austria has served its purpose as my, let's say, buffer against Italy. And I hope to provoke some English-German conflict, which is so far not working out yet. So in 1908, I'm continuing my move into the north, moving into Finland, moving into St. Petersburg, and also moving south. Now south is going quite well. Turkey is annoying. He keeps handing in orders till the very end. So he moves to Ankara. I move to Constantinople. So he remains at one, but he's still not dead yet. At the same time, I do manage to take Norway from England, because Germany is keeping his word, is only protecting his own units, which I really appreciate. So by this time, I'm in a really good position. I've got 12 supply centers now, an extra two. Italy has also gained one. I wiped Austria off the board, so I now have an Italian neighbor. I will never really get on speaking terms with Italy, but it's also not necessary, because I have plenty of units to defend him off. Germany is still acting as my buffer. Yeah, so it's a perfect situation. So by this time, I'm really confident with 12 supply centers and the other ones only at 6, and a little bit scattered as well, that I have a good chance of actually winning this game. In 1909, I continue. I make a deliberate bounce in Armenia to hold off Turkey, moving my fresh fleet into the Barents Sea and trying to grab North Sea, which actually, to my surprise, worked out, because I'm grabbing it straight away with just an unsupported attack. Quite sloppy of England, to be honest. And you see, I trust Germany a little bit, but just in case, I support hold my armies. What you can see is I respect the boundaries in Prussia and Silesia, and also in Baltic Sea that we have. Moving from Galicia to Bohemia in fall 1909, not to attack Germany, but to put pressure on Italy. But at the same time, you see Italy in the spring, sorry to forget that, has moved into Eastern Mediterranean. He's saying that to create a stronghold against me, but really he just wants to attack me because he sees the danger I'm posing to him. So he's moving into Aegean Sea. I kind of saw that move coming, but I decided I wanted to eliminate Turkey first, because Turkey has been there with one supply center for so long. Italy is support holding all his units so far, so he's claiming the move from Ion to Aegean. It's not an attack on me, just a security buffer as he poses it, but I don't really believe it. I do manage to convoy an army to the British Islands and take Edinburgh, finally, after 9 years. And you can see I put some real pressure on England. Germany acting as my perfect buffer here. We're not moving against each other. He is moving into Burgundy and Gascony. It's all fine. I don't care about that part of the map for now. So I'm mentioning the retreats here specifically, mainly because Turkey has to retreat. It doesn't have any centers left. I gained 2 centers, so I'm at 14 now, and the remaining parties are at 6, and England at 2. So yeah, it's looking really good now. Italy is fully seeing the danger of my solo victory. He's also mentioning that to me. Any deal is off the table with me. So I say, fine, then let's go and kill each other. So he's moving into Smyrna. Bit of a weird move. I think he either made a mistake or he wanted to prove a point that he was not attacking me yet. I'm convoying a second army onto the British Islands. So yeah, things looking pretty good from here. In the fall, I managed to take both London and also Liverpool. Italy moves into Smyrna. I could have prevented that, but I decided it was more important to get fleets out. So get fleets out of the Black Sea area into the Mediterranean. And you see, I don't attack Italy yet completely, but a little bit. It's sort of, we're seeing that we have to attack each other somehow. Italy at the same time takes Berlin, which is pissing the German off, which is good for me. Because Germany is now not focused on me, but on Italy. Again, an Italian army in Berlin is not a pretty thing to see, playing Germany. I only gain one supply center, so I decide to build an extra army in Warsaw, mainly focused against Italy. England is dead by now, good news, and France and Germany are still at 5 or 6. So yeah, by this time, I'm pretty convinced I'm actually going to get this solo. Only Italy can prevent it. But Germany and Italy are not cooperating. Actually, they're fighting against each other, so Italy has to retreat to Silesia. Yeah, just having an overall battle with Italy. I know I will get Smyrna back. I'm also already attacking the channel successfully. Germany makes a bit of an odd move from Denmark to Sweden, but okay, I just let him be. And again, he conquers Burgundy, I think for the 6th time this game, or 7th time, but not really gaining the gains that he needs to kill France. In 1911, I gain another supply center, so I'm at 16 now. And I know it needs to happen next year, because even Germany is starting to communicate a bit vaguely to me that this buffer thing is not really working for him anymore, etc., etc., so all I need is speed now. So I do that. I attack Trieste, I attack Smyrna, I attack Belgium with another convoy, which is quite nice. And I also move in to attack Sweden, because by this time I can break my word against the German. Italy retreats again to Berlin. In the fall I take Sweden, I take Smyrna, I take Trieste. I actually lose Belgium, but I can retreat that to Holland, so I gain 3 supply centers, meaning I'm pretty happy, and I've gained my solo. If I look back at the game, I think the key moments were in 1905, where Germany decided to attack me, and in 1908 again, when Germany decided his attack was completely unsuccessful, and we kind of agreed on a non-aggression pact after that. And that's basically been the strategy from the beginning, to use both Austria and Germany as a buffer. Of course, I ate my buffer in Austria later, but that is fine. But those buffers are so important, because two of the most nasty opponents that Russia have are Turkey and England. And the main thing Turkey and England have in common is that they have corner positions and they are difficult to fight. So Turkey, of course, you saw, very difficult to completely eliminate. And the same with England. I did not expect to move all the way back to Moscow, basically, and then all the way gain Scandinavia again. I would have hoped that would have gone a bit faster. But basically the German attack made that happen. But overall, very successful game for me. Thank you for listening, and see you next time.